Good morning, students. In the last lecture, what we have seen is what is motion and the basic concepts of the motion, chapter motion. We have seen what is distance, what is displacement. Today, we are going to discuss it further, what is uniform motion and what is non-uniform motion. हमने last class में discuss किया था what is uniform motion. Uniform motion किसे कहते हैं? When an object travels equal distance in equal time. That means if s upon t is constant or uniform, we call it as uniform motion. And this s upon t is also known as speed, where s stands for distance and t stands for time. What is the unit of distance? Meter. Unit of time? Second. So unit of speed is meter per second. So, if the speed is constant, it is called uniform motion. और अगर speed constant नहीं है, मतलब या तो distance same time interval में same नहीं है, या same distance different time intervals में आ रहा है, तो उस condition में s upon t is not constant and it is called non-uniform motion. So, we have got our first formula of this chapter. For uniform motion, v is equal to s upon t. This is our first formula for this chapter. Only for uniform motion, as I told you in the last lecture also. And the unit of v is meters per second. Now, let us talk about non-uniform motion. We said, if s upon t is not constant, that means if s and t are not changing in the same fashion, then it is called non-uniform motion. Now let us take this example. We have been driving. हम लोग साइकिल चलाते हैं, हम लोग दौड़ते हैं, हम लोग पैदल भी चलते हैं, हमारे पेरेंट्स कार चलाते हैं, स्कूटर चलाते हैं, क्या होता है? चलिए बात करते हैं हमारे पेरेंट्स की. घर से गाड़ी स्टार्ट की, गाड़ी स्टार्ट करने के बाद क्या होता है? उस समय स्पीड क्या होती है? जीरो. तो व्हाट दे डू? दे एक्सेलरेट द व्हीकल, इंक्रीज द स्पीड. इंक्रीज द स्पीड कंटिन्यूअसली इंक्रीज नहीं करते हैं, एक स्पीड पे जाकर के कांस्टेंट हो जाते हैं, फिर अचानक कुछ सामने आता है या ट्रैफिक सिग्नल आता है तो स्पीड रिड्यूस कर देते हैं, हो सकता है जीरो भी करना पड़ता है, फिर एक्सेलरेट करते हैं. सो व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम आवर हाउस, सपोज दिस इज द टाइम व्हेन वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम आवर हाउस, वी स्टार्ट द व्हीकल हियर, इंक्रीज द स्पीड, देन रन एट अ कांस्टेंट स्पीड. This is speed and this is time. Then maybe decrease the speed, increase the speed, again come back to zero, for some time stand here, again increase. Now, अगर हम लोग इस total journey को छोटे छोटे टुकड़ों में देखें तो ये non-uniform motion है क्योंकि speed बढ़ रही है, ये uniform motion है क्योंकि speed constant है, ये भी non-uniform motion है, ये नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन है, ये नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन है, ये यूनिफॉर्म मोशन है क्योंकि व्हीकल रेस्ट पे है, ये नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन है, अगेन दिस इज यूनिफॉर्म मोशन. सो कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म मोशन एंड मोशंस लाइक दिस इज कॉल्ड नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन, और इट कैन बी, वी विल बी कमिंग डाउन टू इट, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ मोशन इट इज कॉल्ड. Now, we have two different types of non-uniform motion. एक है जहां हमारी स्पीड, हमने बात की थी स्पीड की, यहां पे स्पीड इज व्हाट? इट इज रेट ऑफ कवरिंग ऑफ डिस्टेंस, दैट मीन्स व्हाट एवर डिस्टेंस वी हैव कवर्ड दैट इन अ गिवन टाइम. If the rate of change of speed is कॉन्स्टेंट रेट ऑफ चेंज और स्पीड इज कॉन्स्टेंट एंड अदर केस इज वेन द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ स्पीड इज नॉट कॉन्स्टेंट. When the rate of change of speed is constant means what? It is either increasing or decreasing at a constant rate. That means if I call this as the initial speed u and this as the final speed v, then v minus u is the change of speed and rate of change means upon time. If this is constant, we call it as uniformly accelerated speed. And this constant is known as acceleration. हम लोग गाड़ी में accelerate करते हैं, ये वही acceleration है. Now we are giving a technical meaning to this word acceleration. Now you see what is the unit of speed, meter per second, upon time second, so this becomes meter per second square. So unit of speed is meter per second and unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Now this speed can be positive, acceleration can be positive, that we call as acceleration, and if this is negative, that means if the speed is decreasing as shown in the second line here, then we call it as deceleration or retardation. Deceleration or retardation. And the unit of both is meter per second square. But if it is not constant, we call it as non-uniformly accelerated speed. And this is also known as non-uniform motion, non-uniformly accelerated speed. Now, this is what we have seen as uniform motion, non-uniform motion. Now let us see what we had discussed in our last class was displacement. We had talked about displacement. We said it is the shortest distance between the original position and the final position. Now if I say v is equal to s upon t, where s is the displacement, then this is known as velocity. Then this is known as velocity. Now the difference between velocity and speed is velocity, just like displacement, is a vector quantity and this is a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity. Just remember from this word s and this word v, you will remember it. Now velocity and speed, can speed be negative? No, speed can be zero, but speed cannot be negative. Cannot be negative. It can be negative. How it can be negative? Now suppose my displacement is negative divided by time, as we have seen in the last class, displacement is negative divided by time gives you a negative velocity. It can be negative, it cannot be negative. There are many more differences between this. There are at least three more differences which I want you people to work out at home and come as a solution for the next class.
and that is a homework for you from this class. Now coming down to again non-uniform motion, and we are going to talk about uniformly accelerated motion. I'll write in short, uniformly accelerated motion. Now we said V minus U upon T is equal to acceleration, which is constant. Or if we solve it, we get V minus U is equal to AT, or V is equal to U plus AT. This is our first equation of motion for any type of motion, where A is constant, that means uniformly accelerated motion or uniform motion where A is zero. Now if we see V is equal to U if A is equal to zero, so that becomes uniform motion. So this is our first equation of motion. Now coming down to, suppose I say you are traveling a distance of 100 kilometers and you are taken, maybe you are traveled at driven at 20 kilometers per hour, 80 kilometers per hour, 70 kilometers per hour, it's symmetrical. But you have taken 4 hours to travel the total distance of 200 kilometers. You have taken 4 hours to cover 200 kilometers. So what was your average speed? Average speed was 200 kilometers is the total distance upon 4 hours, or we can say S, that is total distance upon total time, gives me V bar, that is the average speed. V bar is equal to S upon T. So this is our equation for average speed. Second, this is for uniform motion, this is also equal to U plus V upon 2. How we will derive it when we are doing graphical representation of the speeds and derivation through graphical manners, उस समय हम लोग इसको derive करेंगे. अभी आप याद रखिए कि average speed is equal to U plus V upon 2, that is S upon T, total distance upon total time. This is also applicable only for uniformly accelerated motions. Now, if I see this, U plus V upon 2 is equal to S upon T, or V is equal to 2S upon T minus U, or I can see the combinations here. S is equal to U plus V into T upon 2. Now what is V here? U plus AT. Let us see. U plus AT into T upon 2 is equal to S. And from where we have got this? From our first equation of motion. That is 2UT plus AT square upon 2, or UT plus half AT square. This is our second equation of motion. Now there is one more equation of motion which we are going to see now. Again, we said V is equal to U plus AT, S upon T is equal to U plus V upon 2, or I can say T is equal to 2S upon U plus V. Let us put this in this equation, or in this, the first equation. we get V is equal to U plus A into 2S upon U plus V Let us take the LCM as U plus V. So this becomes U square plus UV plus 2AS. And if I take this is V. Or I can write V into U plus V is equal to U square plus VU plus 2AS. And this becomes, if I expand this is UV plus V square. Is equal to this UV UV gets cancelled, so I get V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. This is my third equation of motion. So we have seen the three equations of motion plus the formula for the average speed. In the next class, we will do some numericals on this. Three equations of motions, average speed and the uniform motion, and also go ahead with the graphical representation. Till that time, keep enjoying, keep studying, keep safe, and do not forget to like the videos and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much.